소비지에 대한 표현이 아 내가 막 노래 비보다야 그리고 막 쉬어있어
好,那我们再继续往下讲心理学的部分
Let's continue the teaching, first teaching of Lorik
어디 있거든? 라고 하셨다 아 우리 국민들 최근 남아들었지 학생들이 그 멤버는 이분이 공인신앙당 대발신앙당의 공인신앙당에 있으니 그래서 상시
在上一堂课里面我们大约的提到了一下关于小圣以及大圣他们在这个新的部分他们有着不同的论述
Last session we were talking a little bit about the differences of mind in Hinayana and Mahayana Buddhism.
어떤 일을 했는가? 그러다가 대법님 받은 대법신부 남지 때문에 실세민세 때문에 사우사비 역시 이방고에 좀 당대 남아달라 그때 대법신부 당 대법님 받 니가 비 남이야 때 또 늘상 슈조네 다 나도 대법신부 당 대법님 받 니가 비 세민세 사우모데 아니 가해 말하면서 말을 빌값으로 아니 가래 되니 다음 주가 세 차로 유래 생 썰로 어디 아니 장기 세대 로스 많이 따도나 이제 세대기 아니 썰이 뭐당 다 동별한 시기기 남에게 한 마코네 유라 아니 가래 셴바단 제비 왕기 아니 가래가 말이바 세비 된다도나 다음 주가 세대 차로 유래 Vita Jidani, Jidani, that don't keep a member in it, keep a chibu in it, same say the seven more Matomana, Maribi Kinchin, and DK Vita, Yulani, Zibadan, Shibu, and the thousands of us, the Hatch of the race.
Now,
Lorik
just said, 它就是明的那个部分，他们其实在这部分是有后通的程序的。那他们也还提到，还有一个看法是在讲到说，这个关于心，它是明的，它的本质其实是明，但是为什么有时候会出现一些好像看起来不是明的状况？譬如他是指说，那时候是因为无明的关系，或者是因为无明的关系，你对于你产生的执着，然后你产生了。
So just now we were talking about in both Hinayana and Mahayana Buddhism what is both agreeable is the clarity or luminosity of the mind, which is the common ground in both doctrines of Buddhism. But since there is a clarity or clearness or luminosity of the mind, why sometimes there is unclearness or not so clear in the mind. It's because there is a so-called ignorance. Because of ignorance, there is a clinging, a habit of clinging is aroused. And then there will be greed. From clinging, there will be greed. So there will be attachment to a sense of self.
That is the same subtle mode, the subtle and tongue and shin, the society, matomi kinchin, the subtle mode, the matomi kinchin, the subtle mode, the latin, and man said the subtle, tongue and shin, but the hammock. But I don't know, the tongue and shin hammock over the thing, the doubt.
尤其是 当你的心被这样的一个被无明所蒙蔽的时候，他就显现他的显现不出，他就没有办法看到自己在明中有空的那个部分。他因为他遮蔽了空的那一个面相，于是他就会产生了强烈的执着。也就是说，他将因为不认识到这个明空无二，明空不二，不认识到这个，他没有办法认识到这个明空双运的这个本质，于是他就只看到明的那部分，而把这种明当作自己执着的一个对象，他只取这个明而产生的这个我执，然后依于这样的一个执着，然后再跟接着产生的贪嗔痴三毒，于是各种的不快乐的很多就会这样子产生了。不认识明空不二，就是他没有看到空的部分，所以他就对于明非常的执着，然后这样的我执升起产生的三毒，将这个明当这个明当作是我的。
So, when there is an attachment to, or when the mind is polluted or defiled by ignorance, and there won't be a combination of luminosity and emptiness. What it means is that because the mind. When our mind is defiled or is disturbed by ignorance, we cannot recognize the combination of luminosity and emptiness as one. We only can see the luminosity clearness, and then we get attached to or clinging to the luminosity as if it's the only one and separated from the emptiness, and we cannot recognize the emptiness at all. So then there is a sense of clinging to self, and from there there is a generation of three poisons.
一个现象，这样的一个流程，也就是说，你不认识到心的本质其实是明空双运、明空不二的。好，于是你产生了，于这样的一个状况，其实就叫做无明，然后产生了接下来所有一连串的一个连锁效应。其实这连锁效应就是我们所俗称的轮回。好，也就是当你不认识到心的本质是明空双运的时候，其实轮回就开始了。而一旦你认识到心的本质其实是明空双运的时候，其实你也自然从轮回中解脱。
When we cannot recognize the nature of the mind, which is the there's non-duality, or you can say it is a combination of luminosity and emptiness as one at the same time, then there is a beginning of samsara. But on the other hand, if we can recognize the non-duality or a combination of luminosity and emptiness as one, together, that time, that's also, we can be free from samsara. So, in sum, the nature or the essence of the mind is actually a combination or a non-duality of luminosity and emptiness together as one. However, we are unable to recognize the non-duality of this, the essence of the mind. There is a great deal of ignorance. And from ignorance, we then have the problem of three points. And then because of the three points, which is anger, greed, and ignorance, we then commit ourselves into making a lot of bad behaviors, bad deeds. Then that's the cause of suffering.
What are the end of that? That's the end of the day. 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 That's the
所以其实刚刚讲到的这个关于认识到心的本质，就是你要能够如实的见到心的本质这件事情，它有什么样一个重要性呢？我们可以从就是可以从升起的这种顺序跟去把它倒着过来去把它若做佛学密常用中升至就流转门跟环灭门这样来讲，就是说升起的顺序跟倒着你想要把它铲除的顺序这样来讲。好，那为什么讲到这个呢？因为刚刚提到说你就是因为你心的本质还是怎么样的，你就没有照着它本来该是的样子去看它，因为你不认识到它本来的那个样子。 好，这个就叫做无明。然后因为无明，所以你才产生了执着，你就产生了烦恼跟业。然后而由于你的一种行业，你的造业，而产生了各种种种的苦乐的各种感受，这个其实就是称为轮回。所以这就是一个流转的，就是从正的顺序去看它的一个产生的一个状轮回的产生的状况。所以如果当你想要消灭这个轮回的时候，我们就应该要从就要反着去推，可以说这个现在轮回的苦乐是从哪里来的呢？它是从业跟烦恼来的，就是从你的作为，你的作为是从你的烦恼来的。那你的烦恼是怎么来的？你的烦恼是由于你有执着来的。你的执着是怎么来的呢？你的执着是由于你没有去看清楚本来你的心该是什么样子，因为你不明白，也就是无明，就是不明白你的心本来是什么样子，所以才产生的。所以一旦你看清楚了，后面这些也都不会存在了。
So, when we say about the essence or the nature of the mind, if we can see the mind itself as it is, then there won't be a problem. But since we cannot do that, this is why we have to study this class. Is that right? And we have to...learn how to eliminate let me put in this way. When we say there is a, we can say from the causal order of this whole process of from ignorance to attachment,to karma, to klesha, suffering, and bitterness. This is the order of how our suffering has been generated. But also we can reverse this order, that means that we eliminateThis whole cycle of samsara from looking into the karma and klesha, and then how we clean ourselves, or how we attach to the outside and to the sense of self, and then how do we eliminate the whole cycle of this samsara? Actually, at the end, we have to really learn how to recognize or to see our mind as it is.
就是它的差别是巨大的。如果你认识心的本质的话，其实它就是涅槃，是寂静，然后其实你也可以说它就是解脱。那如果你不认识心的本质，就我们刚刚以上所说的，它其实它的结果就是它就是轮回。 那我们刚才讲到说一个轮回产生的顺序的时候，提到说当你不认识新的本质的时候，你产生了不认识新的本质的那个状态是无明，于是你产生了我执，因为我执你产生了三毒。有人也许会觉得说我执跟三毒这有关系吗？好，其实真的仔细去想的话，我执跟三毒其实根本就是不可分开，就是它不是两件事情。
Okay, so right now we were talking about whether we can recognize the nature or the essence of the mind or not will make a big difference. If we can do that, if we can recognize the nature and essence of the mind, we will ultimately reach Nirvana, or you can say,we will be free from samsara, and that will be a peaceful state of mind in tranquility. And, but when we cannot do that, when we cannot recognize the nature of the mind, we will then be in the cycle of samsara. And so just now we were talking about how to reverse the cycle of samsara by looking intothe karma, klesh, and then from karma, there's, we can see the kleshas we have, and then from the kleshas, we can learn how habitual habits, or how we get attached to, or how we cling ourselves into different type of things.And so on and so forth. But people might be confused about what's the relationship between attachment to self and three poisons. What are these two connected? Actually, these two, attachment to self and three poisons, are actually not separable.
그래서는지난아니창소님과소파들죠아니나도진발되는중얼을해야하나나도진발되는대대중얼이스그와이내양다단얘기카가소도요말해서깨자리가려라고있나공도쉬가나신기때는나머지가죽세대그와나머지가죽세대니에공도빛샤가나신기코아니자도는공부미자와라대비찬에공부미자와미자와라대비찬에민아니미자와지다샤마도아니아빼나하다민등기된통대에다숙달라서도무슨유등서유대가낭신기디레지유를해서는디레지유말을쓰니공도쉬인다그와니에게다다공부하더니지당민기남을쉐바내에송해남을쉐바트룹스나야리남을쉐바기에세나야리민디다만관리기시도에따와내려가있는데아니공부공부수술메자와라떼니아니가는떼니찬에는따와있습니다이나양공부메자와라떼니따와내려가있다바디아니다만마음을통주게되려있다능기되는족세당되니대단한신기다떼포바당대단한신기매도당어디대단한신기카라유에대비찬에아니니족세대디아니딱가브레디파게디나도르세지카다샤와니저따원데르베스는마리에드라싱이슈인바르바괜찮은간지스따버리나나낙지딱코떼막떼막메자베찬에아니델라떼비민시와메자와따원데찬은이경을빼자네경은타다델라유대와있는델라유기기미샤버리망예레드도파게디미샤버리사제신바지레드도사제유델라유기기디샤버리이나양미디카가요마니찌가요마니좋아이나양이것은길을잃으셔미파괴를잃으셔미세디가르사버스는율아니최악사제딜을잃어있는데딜을잃으셔미차버리파괴되는사제딜을잃어있는데딜을잃으셔미차버리마도비셔미찌가버리오디는신기하다강수받아들시기된하다다차소님몬데조양당진한테는깨버리디이나야차소와소가당진이쉐도겨버지여러서는요말을굉장히대리스
为什么会这么说呢？因为你当然可以说 三毒烦恼跟我执好像有些不同吧，因为三毒烦恼是从我执产生的。好，可是你再仔细想一想，你刚刚道理这么说没有错，它是从我执产生的，但是这个他们之间的关系其实是像什么呢？其实有点像是我们刚刚说的，在讲到心内学一就各种心事的状态的时候，我们曾经举一个例子，譬如说，翻译小梅这边坐在这边，我们会说今天的课堂上的小梅，然后我们会说在捷运站的小梅，在板桥的小梅，但是他们并不是三个不同的小梅，他们只是因为他基于今天这一个小梅他在哪里的时候，我们会给他取一个名字，我们会命名的时候会这么命名，所以因为今天所产生的那个烦恼，哈，说各种，我们讲到三毒烦恼的时候，它所缘的那个境，或者是说它所产生的原因不同，你可能会安立它不同的名字。然后，但是除此之外，只是因为它所依靠的基础不同，而给它命名的时候命名上不同的名字。但是除了这个之外，你要说三毒烦恼，它就不是我执吗？其实它们是不可分的。好，它只是因为基础不同而给他们安立上不同的名字，而并不是说，他是从他产生的，但是他不是他，但是不是这样的意思。他是从三毒烦恼是从我执产生的没有错，但是三毒烦恼其实他跟我执其实是不可分的。然后刚刚Ken举一个例子，就是说这种只是在命名上面的时候，因为那个新升起的缘不一样，而给予不同的命名。但是他们的这种命名的不同，这种不同跟你说花跟杯子不同，杯子跟桌子不同，这种不同是不一样的，他们不是这种不同。
I'll try.
Okay. Just now we were trying to answer or to discuss about the attachments to self versus three poisons and kleshas. What are the differences, or are they connected? Are they the same? Actually, three poisons and kleshas. Three poisons and kleshas are all derived from attachments to self. In the last session, we were talking about the states of mind, or we were talking about the six consciousnesses. We gave an example of Xiaomei. There are three kinds of Xiaomei. One is Xiaomei in the classroom, one is Xiaomei at MRT station, and the third Xiaomei is in Banqiao. Are they three different Xiaomeis? No. They are not. They are the same person. Actually, there is only one Xiaomei here. Here, they're actually the same person, not three different people. It's just the naming. The naming sometimes will make you have an illusion of differences. Likewise, three poisons and attachments to self. These are just different namings. Actually, the conditions which causes or the conditions depend upon. Then there will be different. Naming for as of three poisons or attachments to self. So the difference is about the naming or about the conditions dependent upon. So it's not the differences like in tables or the cups or the flowers. These are the three different items, not only naming, not only the causal conditions, but actually different items.
어떤 디인들 때문에 어떤 아니 变成康萨米扎瓦下巴的，那那米扎瓦的约巴的店呢？康萨米扎瓦送下来蛮多个，康萨光米扎瓦的那个下巴买的多吧？
所以就像说有一个人，我们有时候给他不同的名字，有时候是依于他在不同的场域，你就有给他不同的称呼，可是并不代表真的有不同的三个人。
哦，我变天当台湾人呀，先天啊，你紧张没招，差不多紧张就先天了，你没招没招大不了，都
是。所以，
你是看了就有点不新鲜，那你肯定觉得这是这是什么？
所以心也是一样的，他可能会因为依于他当时的那种执着的方式不同，而给他命了不同的名字，给这个心取一个不一样的名字。可是并不代表说他们是三个不一样的心，各种不同的心。
So just now we were using Xiaomei or using a person's name as an example. We can call this person with different names according to where she is or what roles she's playing. Then we'll give this person different names. It's not saying that these are different people.Actually, it's only one person. So is with the mind. We will give the mind different names or name the mind differently according to the attachments arise at that time.
正在我们为什么要解释说认识到心的本质就可以让你解脱轮回这件事情是非常重要的。因为假设你认为说有那种没有我执的三毒烦恼的话，好，就是说除去我，就是我执是一块，然后三毒烦恼是一种，或者说有一些三毒烦恼它其实是没有我执的。好，如果你认为是这样的话，我们刚刚前面那一段就是要说，其实三毒烦恼它绝对是不离我执。只要我执没有我执的话，它就不会有三毒烦恼。所以一旦你认为说有可能有那种没有我执的三毒烦恼的话，那你断我执，好，或者说你断我执就没有什么意义了。那我们说断我执要从你真的认识，你就是因为不认识心的本质，你才会产生我执嘛。好，如果说断我执变得没有意义的话，你去看认清楚心，它对于解脱就没有什么意义。就是变成说你认识心不见得认识心它可以断我执，可是有一些三毒烦恼还是会存在，就会变成这个情况。所以我们一定要建立起一种，你要相信说三毒烦恼跟我执其实就是不可分的。好，那你才会知道说你要能够去去除掉你所有的三毒烦恼。三毒烦恼就是痛苦的成因嘛，你要去除掉所有的轮回的痛苦，你要去除掉三毒烦恼，其实你就是一定要断掉我执，也就是你一定必须要正式的去认识你的心。
Okay,
So we have been had some time. We have been having some time discussing about three poisons, kleshas, and so on and so forth. Why it is necessary and why is it important? Because if there's no recognition about the nature and essence of the mind, there is no way for us to be free from samsara, and there's no way for us to reach nirvana. Please don't think there is a kind of attachment. There is a kind of self-attachment which is free from three poisons. There is another kind of self-attachment which is free from kleshas. There's no such thing like that. All the attachments to self are is totally inseparable. It's no different from three poisons and kleshas. If we think there is another self-attachment free from three poisons, excuse me, I think I make a mistake.
有没有三毒是没有我指的哦，好好好，因为刚好英文有点颠倒，好，OK，好，中文跟英文要怎么
OK, there's a difference between Chinese and English. So, excuse me, let me make a correction. OK, some people might think, is there a three poison that is out there that is free from self-attachment? Is there a such thing like that? No, actually, there's no such thing. All poisons are, when we talk about poisons and kleshas, there has to be an attachment to self. These three are not separable. When we cannot recognize the nature and essence of the mind, there has to be an attachment to self. So how do we be free then? We have to then eliminate all three poisons, and that's the time we definitely will. That's the time, only at when the freedom from self-attachment will be happening. And also that's the time we can, and so then that is why it's so important for us to learn how to recognize or be aware of the mind.
Gansu chule shendu juwaji yoyorosa na gansu chule shendu dhyamari ina ya gansu chula gansu balab sijin huyaya ming tangi warwa ina ya tama ya gansu balab di gansu chule chungbali chungonari gansu chule shendu yomari o tena shen gansu chule nena gansu chule tela tina dhani gansu balab diyan chimbo chungru kani ina ya dhyamari o pe tena dhawar la tela singi ngogo di ani jitawa shindu tonga ani singi ngogo tele ani kare
马通一见起来，道路怎么，道路怎么了？在查索里面，查索里面的，其实身体我的指导是通了，那你看嘞，啊，道路怎么没办法？道路怎么没呢？查索里面我那说的没办法，第一次呢，那你查索里面我那说的，那你，啊，道路怎么先，大部分先别我先都没，先完当当，当真的先都没，先跟真的直接没的，啊，那个意思。
举个例来讲哦，我们会有一个名词，我们会说，比如说波浪，好，或者说海浪，好了。那我们有一个词汇说海洋或说海水，好，这个名词上来看，你就觉得海水是海水，但是想要波浪的时候，你就想要有大浪有小浪。可是其实不管是大浪还是小浪，它其实你能够说它是没有海水的吗？它不是海水吗？其实不管大浪还是小浪。 它都必须是它有海洋而它都是因为有海洋才会有大浪跟小浪的。一旦没有海洋，没有海洋或者你说没有海水的话，那不管是大浪还是小浪，它都没有地方可以升起。好，所以今天的三毒烦恼跟我执的关系，其实就像是海浪跟海水的关系一样。三毒烦恼会产生，也是因为有我执。只要就像没有了海水，不管任何的大浪和小浪都不会升起。只要没有我执，任何的各种的烦恼，其实或大或小的烦恼，什么都不会再升起了。好，那就像这样的一个例子一样，所以今天我执的产生，是因为你不认识到你自心，不认识到心的一个自心，不认识到心的本质的关系，你才会产生的那种错误的执着。所以一旦你今天不想要有会产生痛苦的这些三毒烦恼，你一定要从认识心的自信，然后去断执，断除我执来着手。
可以说最后一句吗？
就是你不想要有三毒烦恼的那些痛苦的结果，那你就一定要去去除掉，就是看不清楚自心本性的这种我执，就要断除我执，那你就要认识自心，这样就像要没有海水就没有海浪。
Let's take another analogy, for example, as if in waves and sea ocean or water, sea water. When we go to the ocean or go to the sea, we will see waves. There are big waves and small waves. Do you think waves is not related to the sea? The waves is not related or have anything to do with water, with seawater? Are they totally not related to each other? Of course, if there's no seawater, there's no waves, right? So when you see the waves, it's definitely related to the sea and to the water. Likewise, the attachments to self and three poisons and kleshas are the same, like are interconnected or intertwined, are related to and inseparable to each other. And it's just because of the self-attachment which stops us from recognizing the nature and the essence of the mind. That's why we are in the suffering of samsara. So if we want to be free from the sufferings of samsara and sufferings of three poisons, we have to eliminate or to be away from what stops us from seeing the mind, which is the attachments.
我在第七堂第一个呢，那么上节课呢，那不是提拔全部，提拔全部来呀？对呢，多一人班长，那个人班二个呢，多一人班王都全部一样。但他的身体我同样，他呢，开心不一般的是吧？因为他。别人约定别人哪里写个一百一的呀？身体我的太阳能身体通畅的，他不能着急我多呗。身体我通过的这个经验，哪里太阳能身体我通的，通过写有的是吧？那身体我通的，他得了写用对了的，那提拔全部当机的呢？刚上个当兵嘛的，初级当兵的就是通过了通的写有的，我太阳能身体的呢，那那边就告诉一百一呢的呢，那第三通畅还是通过的那个一百一呢？
那刚刚讲到的是，就是事实上这样子的一个，就是认识心是心的本质是非常重要的。这一点 其实虽然是大圣非常看重的，但大圣里面其实有精圣跟密圣。那精圣的在大概的一个看法就是诸如刚刚说的，那关于密续里面其实也非常强调必须要去认识心的本质。那在密续的一个修持里面，其实上师在指引弟子去认识不过认识无我这件事情的时候，因为我们刚刚提到我执嘛，你要去断掉我执，在去认识无我这件事情的时候，他会不管说包括给哪，就是缺给达妹当当三给达妹，对吧？对，那密续里面也会提到有人无我、法无我，但在指引这个无我的时候，他们上师会教导的方式，他会有透过升起次第跟圆满次第的一个修行来教导。
升起往往当同样的，他的修行得了的呢，提拔南无三地位，提拔起我，提拔起我来的呢，都有什么？那有什么？你能多少个人跟他说呢？对呢，考上个大学吧，当的呢。去给他们的那个通过是一个是原来的那是因为我同他去当的那他那那边告诉他的那基本上那么重要的那么重要的那是因为我同他
去，对不起重来的，就是应该是这样说，就是大圣里面分为精圣跟密圣，而在指引心的指引说去引介心的这个部分，或者说指引弟子怎么样去看到心的本质的这一个部分，在精舍里面他会透过教导弟子人无我跟法无我的这方面的教授来让来引荐心的本质是什么。在精舍的部分是透过人无我跟法无我的教授，那在密舍的部分呢，他就是透过生缘次第的这样的一个教授，就是升起次第跟圆满次第的教授来让你去引荐你了解心的本质。
这场可以上
人无我法无我
self-person 人无我 is a self-person
self-person
and another one is Kirim is a generation stage, I think. Generation stage, and Yuanman is a completion stage. Completion stage.
Okay. Thank you. Okay. So we've been talking a lot about recognition, the essence or the nature of the mind is very, very important. It's very crucial. In Mahayana Buddhism, there are two ways of looking at it from Tantra or from Sutra, from Sutra doctrine and some Tantra practice. Vajrayana and Sutrayana, okay, excuse me. So in Mahayana, there are two ways of saying one is Vajrayana, one is Sutrayana.
What is Sutra?
Sutra.
Sutra. And what is that?
Tantra. Okay, just Tantra is enough. Okay. One way is Sutra and the other, schools. Yeah, there are two different schools. One is Sutra school, the other is Tantra school. And in Sutra school, it puts more emphasis, when a guru is showing a way of liberation to the followers, in Sutra school, it puts more emphasis on teaching disciples about 人无我, no clinging to self. How do we, in Sutra, how does a guru teach a disciple to recognize the nature of the mind is by showing 人无我, by showing how
to,
to
so it means, for example, thinking selfless of person.
cleansing self as a person, clinging self as a person.
Yeah, yeah.
So the guru.
然后是,
so the guru will show the disciples about.
刚才给大姐是人我执，然后刚才给大美巴是大美巴人的。大美巴是人无我。有一个无嘛。
人无我。
对，人无我。大
约巴。
大约巴是我有我执。
So right now is a seventh person is a.人无有人无我。
对，然后说没有。
So when you clean, it's a 卡萨的当机，卡萨的当机 clean, sample person.
Yes.
So opposite when you're going to opposite, then it's clinging selfless of person. So selfless of person and sample person 不一样，当机。
Selfless.
去卡萨的当月，去卡萨当月的查吧，你就开始下步。강사를담임을통통으로강사를담임을강사담임을하니까셀레스장관
一个就是要去解除掉那种对有人的那种执着，就有我的这种执着。另外一个是要解除掉对于现象是实在的这种执着。
Okay.
So we have to realize the nature of selfless of person and selfless of phenomena.In a sutra way.
So Kempala just explained. So in sutra way, the guru will guide the disciples to be free from, to be able to recognize the essence of the mind by recognizing the selflessness
of a person.
And selflessness
of
phenomena. Oh, selflessness of phenomena. 把握 selflessness of a person. 人无我 And so, not to cling to these two types.
When you cling several person, it will create you different kind of negative emotions.
Right.
So, as same as when you click
to selflessness, phenomena,
it will also create different kind of emotion, let you uncomfortable feeling.
Okay.
So when you stop to
clinch
to this object, then it will stop to generate these negative emotions.
So in other words, the guru will guide his students not to clinch to self as a person.Nor to clinch phenomena as the reality.
Yeah.
Okay.、And、That's in the sutra way.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you. I think my lack of understanding also helps. and in tantra way though, the guru will, how do we recognize the nature of the mind? The guru will teach or guide the disciples or followers.By two ways. One is to know how to, it's through two ways. One is generation stage, the other is completion stage. Okay.
Kansar di dam ni beri nilu dam, cuci dam ni beri nilu thong ala dene, dene, ta, koran ala, kan, korji gitu, sendu mau thong ala subi hari, atau yang langsing ni, ngah lami gede di kau su yang, ane sendu mau thong ala tapi, ane kahana dene cebur esen ata, lam kiri jepa dam, lam zobur jepa ni la dene, ane sendu mau cila macam thong kau sejuk, tela dene, ane jiu cua, ane korwa dam.
所以总之呢，今生哦，就是利用教导弟子人无我跟法无我，好去认识教导弟子人无我跟法无我，然后来引荐弟子们新的本质。然后密圣呢，他透过 或者密续，他透过就是升起次第跟圆满次第，迎接弟子们认识新的本质。而认识到新的本质之后呢，自然的就是像刚刚水学院所说的这个顺序，他就是真的能够就是断除掉后面会产生到痛苦的那些种种的轮回。
So, in general, or to sum up, in sutra way, how a guru guide a disciple or follower to recognize the nature of the mind is by showing them to not to cling to self as a person.Nor not to cling phenomena as the reality. Is that right?
Self
or phenomena, both are not clinged to, then that's the time for a follower to be able to recognize the nature of the mind. While as in Tantra way, there's to reach or to recognize the nature of the mind is by generation stage and by completion stage, two ways. So when we are able to recognize the nature and essence of the mind, we then will be able to eliminate the samsara and sufferings.Arrived from self attachments.
So, that thing is, you know, it's a lot of people,
关于心内学第一堂的一个引介的课程哦，那接下来还有三个礼拜，我们会再继续在礼拜天讲授心内学。好，我们今天的课到这里。
So today is our first session, first session about Rilek. This is our first session on Sunday. Next Sunday we will have the second session.So total, there will be four sessions on four Sundays. Today is the first. Thank you, everyone.